Hello, my name is Yiping Wang, and I'm presenting our work on the classification of ovarian carcinoma pathologies by the images using a deep transfer learning strategy inspired by progressive cancer and fast.ai. Ovarian cancer ranks fifth in cancer deaths among women, accounting for more deaths than any other cancer of the female reproductive system in North America. There are five major histological subtypes of epithelial ovarian cancer, and they have distinct morphological, molecular, genetic, and clinical features. Currently, these histotypes are determined by a pathologist's microscopic examination of tumor host cell images. This process has been hampered by poor inter-observer agreement, with Cohen's kappa varying between 0.54 and 0.67. Therefore, fast and automatic computer-aided methods to improve ovarian cancer histotypes classification based on pathologist-like images are needed. We collected and annotated a dataset of 305 host cell images from 159 ovarian cancer patients. Representative areas of tumor in each WSI were annotated by a board-certified pathologist. Figure 1 shows the proposed WSI classification pipeline. Since each WSI is pretty large, for example, 50,000 times 50,000 pixels, we first extract 1024 times 1024 patches from the annotated region, and downsample them to 512 times 512 and 256 times 256 at the input of our proposed patch level classification model. The output of this stage is one of the five class labels for each patch of the WSI. We then represent each slide with a five-dimensional feature vector, with each element representing the number of patches classified as one of the five histotypes of ovarian cancer. Finally, we employ random forest as the classifier that assign a slide to a given overall diagnosis, ovarian cancer, histotypes in our case. We evaluate the proposed workflow using a threefold cross-validation with separate validation and test set. In this slide, I'm going to briefly go over the details of our proposed patch level classifier. To obtain a robust host cell level classifier, it's essential to have an accurate patch level classification. A small patch extracted from WSI with a limited field of view might lose the context of the morphological patterns, which are required to accurately classify a WSI. To extend the field of view while considering the computational limits, tilt patches are usually downsampled from high resolution to low resolution. The trade-off between the set of the field of view and the resolution makes it difficult to balance the context and subtle details in the images. Hence, we propose a two-stage deep transfer learning patch level classification method using progressive resizing, which is not only able to extract the features from larger field of views, but it's also able to further extract the small details from high resolution patches. This is how it works. In stage 1, we feed the 256 times 256 pixel low resolution patches into a pre-trained VGG19 network. Although a network trained on low resolution images will potentially miss subtle features available from high-resolution images, it will likely pick up high-level contextual patterns that are critical for diagnosis and only available in larger field of views. In stage 2, we removed the first convolutional block of VGG19 and added two randomly initialized convolutional blocks at the top of the trained network from stage 1 and feed the 512 times 512 pixel high-resolution patches into the resulting network. In simple words, the weights in stage 2 are initialized by the learned weights from stage 1. In essence, stage 2 takes advantage of the contextual features learned from low-resolution images, plus other essential small details from high-resolution images to further increase performance. Moreover, the randomly initialized convolutional blocks also help to mitigate the risk of overfitting. To demonstrate the utility of our proposed approach of transfer learning, we compare the performance against two approaches as baselines. First, a conventional CNN in which we trained a randomly initialized VGG19 network using 512 times 512 patches. And second, randomly initialized stage 2 network. Table 1 shows the per class and overall performance of the patch level and the whole cell level classifiers. The proposed pipeline performed better than either standard CNNs or pathologists without gynecological pathology-specific training. These results suggest a promising future direction to validate the findings on a larger cohort of patients, as well as exploring other deep learning architectures that incorporate features from different patch sizes.